Other than our own Dr. Ram Chaddha, he's going to tell us his experience with robotic surgeries.
It's a pleasure to be speaking between two people who are extremely close to me at the invitation of the person who held my hand and made me pass MS Orthopedics. Arvind is the guy who held my hand and made me walk through MS Orthopedics. Shekhar Kumta was a role model whom I tried to emulate in more ways than one. And the speaker immediately after me is my childhood classmate and schoolmate, Gautam Chakravarti. So I'm in an extremely cushy position. And I'm here to share my natural stupidity versus the artificial intelligence and robotics. I look back about a decade when I tried to operate and make this young girl straighter than what she came to me with. Like every other orthopedic spine surgeon, I celebrated prematurely. Girl had a neurological deficit, probably related to one of those screws impaling the spinal cord. Where did we go wrong? Was it an error in planning, an error in execution? Was it something that happened during the operation? Was it overconfidence, oversight, or maybe just inadequate training? Whenever we do anything freehand, like the artwork done by my son or the food cooked by my mother, each item is different from the earlier one. Today, technology, including safety measures and the OAM, the SIAM, the neuronavigation, has led us to a situation where we have a robot. A robot which is driven not by my natural stupidity, but by its artificial intelligence. What do these robots do? They help us place these screws as per preoperative plan, precisely, accurately, and with the option of checking them intraoperatively. God forbid, things do change. Where has this brought us? It has brought us to a situation where we have significantly improved in the intraoperative error. A 5% freehand misplacement of screws has gone down to an almost 0.6% mismatch or misplacement of screws, which too has dramatically reduced the neurology. We have a large exodus of these artificially intelligent creatures from various companies who are helping us with spine as well as non-spine orthopedic surgery. We have reached a situation where we have to now believe that our intelligence is being superseded by artificial intelligence. 1997, Kasparov was challenged by Deep Blue. The first two times, Kasparov beat Deep Blue. But the third time, Deep Blue upset Kasparov. An artificial intelligent dethroned the world champion. It's happened again in various games and has now reached the stage where in 2018, Jackie Ma's Alibaba claims that they have artificial intelligently created devices which can read much better than the average human. Have we reached a stage where artificial intelligence is now showing the orthopedic spine surgeon the way out? It is very upsetting. Are we working for the robot, or do we wish to work with the robot? This is something which is bothering me and bothering many of us today. Look at the newspapers. Today, robotic spine surgery or robotic orthopedic surgery is drawing large amount of media coverage. And why is that so? Because artificially, anything, almost anything is being created. That's the amount that has been paid for an artificially created portrait I always believed that you can create a laborer or a craftsman artificially, but rarely can you create an artist. But today, we are having huge steps of AI into healthcare. There will be a time when we'll be paging for Dr. Robot, thanks to these four big American companies, Facebook, Amazon, Google, and Apple. We have sold ourselves completely, and they have analyzed our requirements so algorithmically that with machine and deep learning, they know precisely what we want. Yes, it is intriguing when we can look at a screen and decide how to react to a patient in the ICU, or use a device which takes care of all our assistants and helps us with total knee replacement, or probably sit in an adjoining room while a laparoscopic cholecystectomy is being performed elsewhere. We must look at Isaac Asimov's original work when he said, a robot may not injure a human being, a robot must obey orders, and a robot must protect its own existence. This was 1941, but he is now walking on our land in our shoes. Why is that so? Because robots are routinely carrying on crucial steps in orthopedic knee replacement more precisely than the expert surgeons. Things are looking very, very difficult. There's going to be a situation where in the near-term future, we would be like airline pilots, where we only get in for the takeoff and the landing, while robotics and artificial intelligence will look at our way forward during the procedure. Is this where we are going? The true sign of intelligence is not knowledge, but imagination. The process and the product is being dictated by artificial intelligence, but we have to look at it differently. We have to look between fact and fiction. There is something called as a myth or a perception in between. This is where artificial intelligence will have to bow down to real intelligence. Common sense is not known to the robot. These are tough times, but they will pass. And we have to go through it. And why do I say that? Because I am a born optimist. I strongly believe a robot can replace the mind, the head, which conceives the process. The robot can receive or replace the hand and can achieve an excellent product. He can clean up the floor for us. He can execute the operation step by step. But he cannot replace the purpose of the human being. The heart is within the human being. Only he can decide the pain. And if you recollect shortly, a few weeks back, there has been a death where a robot was attempting to perform a surgery while the surgeons were elsewhere. Please understand, robots can inform, humans communicate. Robots can replace the mind, but they do not have a heart. They can become excellent craftsmen and laborers. They cannot become artists. They may know how and what, the process and the product, but they do not know why. The purpose is not known to them. We are human beings and we will clarify the process. Artificial intelligence is fighting us doctors. Remember, robots can touch, but we will still feel. Robots can hear, but we as doctors need to listen. Robots can look, but we shall see. Robots may have a sight, but only one of you or each one of you has the vision. They can do kriya, they can do their duty, but they cannot do karma. They can contact the patient, but they cannot communicate with the patient. So please remember that artificial intelligence has come to stay, love it or hate it. We cannot let it take over the human being. I started with a situation where we wanted to know whether we were working for the robot or with the robot. My thought is, the future is that we should be working not for or with the robot, but there will be a situation where we cannot work without the robot. Artificial replaced artificial engineering, artificial intelligence, all these will never replace the doctors, but doctors who use AI and robots will replace those doctors who don't. Thank you very, very much for a patient here.